Hello, folks. So in the last video, while discussing about partials, we have used type. Now in this video, we will see what are types. Now before proceeding ahead, I will ask you one question, and that is, which of the below is a valid use of type? You can see the four options and you will answer in the comment section below. I will give you the right answer at the end of the video. So let's get started. So very similar to interfaces, we also have types in TypeScript. The syntax is slightly different. So we can create one type by writing something like this. So let's say type point equals to, and we will have some points. So let's say x, that will be one number. And also in y, we will have another number. And if it's 3D, we will also have z, which is another number. Now we can also create some points. So let me first create the origin point O. The type will be of point. And here I can define the points. So let's say I will give x as 0, y will also be 0. And z will also be 0 because this is the origin. Now any other point also I can create. So let me create one random point P. The type will be of point. And here let's say the x will be 14. The y will be 12 and the z will be 10. And we can also do some console logs. So let me do console log of O and console log of P. If I run this thing, what will I get? So I will do node and then I will run this 6type.js. And we have the following results. So there is nothing unexpected here. So the only difference is that the types will be using one equals to, and then we will create the types. So for interfaces, we don't have equals to, we directly write these things. So this is one basic difference between the types and interfaces. Now let me just create one function. So below, I will create another type, and here I will create one Pokemon type. And this Pokemon type will have the name of the Pokemon, which will be the string. It will also have one level, that will be one number. And lastly, it will also have the type of the Pokemon, which will be another string. It could be one array of strings. So in case a Pokemon has multiple types. Now I will create one function. So let me name one function as Pokemon info. And inside, I will pass one Pokemon of the type Pokemon type. And here, what I will do is I will do some console log. So I will console log my Pokemon name, so Pokemon.name, and I will write as a level, and then I will give my level, so Pokemon.level. So Pokemon has level is Pokemon.type, and we actually cannot get the type like this, so we have to do type 0. So let's say I will only give the primary type, type Pokemon. So that's all I want to write. And lastly, I have to invoke the function. So I will call the Pokemon info, and here I have to pass the things. So let's say I will get the information of Charizard, and we know that Charizard could be of many levels. Let's say this Charizard is of level 50. And lastly, I have to pass the type also. So the type will be fire and flying. Now, this should be one comma, not full stop. So now if I run the same thing, so we have Charizard as level 50 is fire type Pokemon. So this is how we can use like types in brief. So that's all about types in TypeScript. Now there are some additional differences with interfaces, but that we will cover when we are coming to unions. Now coming back to the question that we asked at the beginning. So which of the below is a valid use of type? And the right answer is option C. So that's it for this video. If you have learned something new in this video, consider hitting the like button. It gives me a lot of motivation to create a lot more videos like this. So yeah, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching and bye-bye.